Good morning, 12th standard student. Today we are going to learn definitions of angular velocity, angular acceleration. And the first we will study the angular velocity. It is denoted by the letter omega. The rate of change of angular displacement with respect to time is called as angular velocity of the particle performing uniform circular motion. Angular velocity is equal to angular displacement divided by time, that is omega is equal to small angular displacement delta theta and the small time interval delta t. Therefore, omega is equal to delta theta upon delta t, or limit delta t tends to 0, delta theta by delta t. So omega is equal to d theta upon dt. SI unit of angular velocity is radian per second. Dimensional equation of angular velocity, that is equal to in square bracket omega is equal to in square bracket mass to the power 0, length to the power 0, time to the power minus 1. Now, the second definition that we are going to study, angular acceleration. It is denoted by the letter alpha. The rate of change of angular velocity with respect to time is called angular acceleration. Therefore, the formula is angular acceleration is equal to change in angular velocity divided by time. If we consider, if omega 0 is the initial angular velocity and omega is the final angular velocity, then the change in velocity we can write as omega minus omega 0 divided by time t. Therefore, the formula becomes alpha is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 delta omega divided by delta t. The SI unit of angular acceleration is radian per second square. Dimensional formula of angular acceleration in square bracket alpha is equal to in square bracket mass to the power 0, length to the power 0 and time to the power minus 2. Angular acceleration is a vector quantity. Now we are going to study the relation between linear speed and angular speed. For this derivation, now we have to consider a particle P moving in the anticlockwise direction about the center O. Let us suppose initially the particle is at A. After a time of delta t seconds, let the particle it reaches to the point B, so that its angular displacement is delta theta. Let R be a position vector OA and OB. Here, as the particle is performing uniform circular motion with radius r in anticlockwise direction, let delta s be the linear displacement, delta theta be the small angular displacement. If time interval is very small, then delta t is tends to 0, then arc AB can be considered to be almost a straight line. Therefore, we write V is equal to limit of delta t tends to 0, delta s upon delta t, but delta s is equal to r into delta theta. Therefore, the velocity formula becomes equal to r in bracket limit delta t tends to 0 delta theta by delta t, and therefore finally we get velocity v is equal to radius vector r into angular velocity, that is omega. So in this way, we have derived the relation between linear speed and angular speed, that is linear velocity v is equal to radius into angular velocity.